Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, this is our second session for Quant Workshop. In the previous session, we discussed some problems. In the this session also, we are going to take some more problems, more concepts. You just note down the points that you are not aware of, and you should be revising all the points before you attend the next workshop, right? So just get energized for this session. Now let's see this problem here. X and Y are two different alloys of gold and silver prepared by mixing the metals in the proportion 9:4 and 9:17 respectively. If equal quantities of the alloys are melted to form a third alloy Z, find the ratio of gold and silver. Now we have to take the equal quantity. Let us see. It's 9 + 4, 13. I may assume that's 13 kilogram, and this is 9:17, that means 26 kilogram. Since I have to take the equal quantity, what I'll do? I'll double this. So what if I double this, by maintaining the ratio, I'll be getting 18:8, right? So this is gold, this is silver. In this case, this is gold, this is silver, right? So what will be the ratio? 18 + 9, 27, and 8 + 7, 25, right? So no much calculation, no much paperwork is required. Your answer is the northeast. The ratio will be 27:25, right? This is also 26 kilogram. This is also 26 kilogram. So quite an easy one. Now let's read this story, a time and work problem. A can finish a piece of work alone in 6 days, while B can finish the same in 12 days. That means efficiency of A is double than that of B. They start working together and A quits after 2 days, then B works alone for 3 days, and after 3 days A is called back and he finishes the remaining work alone. Okay, if they are paid rupees this, find the amount that each one gets. Assume that the amount is distributed in the ratio of amount of work that they have done. Okay, quite a simple problem friends. No much paperwork is required. See what exactly is happening. A capacity, or that means, or we can say efficiency of A is that double than that of B, right? Since A is taking 6 days and B is taking 12 days to accomplish the task, they start working together. A is not doing work after 2 days. That means B is working initially for 2 days, because initially A and B starting, B is working for 2 days and then B is working for 3 days more, right? So in all, the total work done by B is of 5 days, right? So the this person can finish the entire task in 12 days. That means in 5 days he might have done 5/12 of the work. That means initially A has done the work, some work in 2 days, then the remaining work also he has done. That means the remaining work and initial work in all 7/12 work has been done by A, because in all B has done just 5/12 of the work, right? So this is the work done ratio. That means this will only be the ratio in which the amount has to be distributed, right? 7:5, or we can say 7/12 into 1008, that is the amount of A. So 7 × 4, 28, yeah, so this will be the correct choice. Okay, so just a conceptual problem, not much paperwork is required. I hope you are clear. Now let's see this one. Increasing the radius of a cylinder by 6 units increases its volume by y cubic unit. Okay, and increasing the height of the same cylinder by 6 units also increases the volume by y cubic units. Okay, if the original height is 2 unit, then the original radius is, okay, what is the volume of the cylinder? That is pi r square h, right? So pi into h is already given, that's 2. So pi, now we want r square. Initially it is r, now it is increased by 6 units, so r plus 6 whole square, and that is actually equal to pi r square h plus 2, right? When we are increasing the height by 6 unit, right? So that's 2 + 6, that's 8. Okay, so let's solve it. So r plus 6 whole square is equal to 4r square, that means r plus 6 is equal to 2r, that means r is equal to 3. I'm sorry, 6. Okay. Now let's see this problem. Grapes contain 75% water. Raisins, which are dried grapes, contain 20% water. Ramesh has 10 kilos of raisins, which he buys for a certain amount of money. If he sells the raisins as grapes after adding water, which is free, what is his profit percent if raisin costs the same as grapes? Okay. Now, precisely, this grapes contain 75% of water, and he is having raisins actually. So raisins contain 20% of water, and he is mixing pure water to it to get 75% of water, because he is trying to make grapes out of raisins. Okay, so 75 minus 20, that's 55, and this is 25. So that's 5:11. So for each 5 kilogram of raisins, he has to mix 11 kilogram of water, right? Now since he is having 10 kilogram of raisins, he has to mix 22 kilogram of water, right? Now what is happening? I assume price of this raisin is say X rupees per kilogram, right? So 10 kilograms, the cost price will be 10X. Right, now the quantity is how much? 22 plus 10, that means 32x, right? So I'm sorry, 32 kilogram now it is. So the price, the selling price is same in both the cases. So 32 kilogram x rupees per kilo, the selling price will be 32x, right? What is the profit? 22x. What is the cost price? 10x. So that's 220%. Okay, as simple as that. Combination of allegation and mixture and profit and loss. Okay. Now let's try this problem. This set contains 3 problems. The problems are based on time, speed and distance. Mohan left Mumbai for Pune. Okay, this is Mumbai, Pune, at 9:30 on his scooter. Straight in Pune for 1 hour and came back. Okay. He passed a truck while coming and going. The truck went to Mumbai from Pune. That means Mohan's direction is this and truck's direction is this. And came back after staying for 2 hours. Okay. Mohan's speed is 25% more than that of the truck. And both traveled at a uniform speed without halting anywhere on the way. Mohan left Pune at 2:30 p.m. and took another 68 minutes to reach Mumbai after passing the truck. Okay, so suppose when he is coming back from the Pune, suppose he is meeting at this point with the truck. Okay, so this distance to this distance he is covering in 68 minutes, right? That means Mohan is coming this way and this is Mohan. And truck is going this way, right? Now one of the question is, Mohan reaches Mumbai at, that means what exactly happening? He is going from Mumbai to Pune, then he is staying there for 1 hour and then he is coming back, right? So Mohan left Pune at 2:30 then, and he is staying there for 1 hour. That means he has reached Pune at 1:30, right? He started at 9:30, reached at 1:30. That means he took 4 hours to cover up this distance, right? Mumbai Pune distance. That means while coming back also he'll be taking 4 hours, right? So when he's starting at 2:30, he'll be taking 4 hours. That means he'll be reaching Mumbai at 6:30 p.m. Okay, so that's pretty simple. Now one of the question is, difference in minutes between the time of the truck leaving Pune and Mohan leaving Mumbai is. Now Mohan is leaving Mumbai at 9:30, that we know. But we don't know when the truck is leaving Pune, right? So let's calculate that. See, we know that the speed ratio of Mohan and truck is 5:4. That means Mohan's speed is 25% more than truck. So Mohan and truck speed ratio is 5:4. That means time ratio will be 4:5. If Mohan is taking 4 hours to cover up this distance, that means the truck will be taking 5 hours to cover up this distance. Okay. Now listen to me carefully. See, Mohan and truck, they are meeting over here, right? After meeting, Mohan is taking 68 minutes to cover up this distance, right? That means truck might have taken how much time? 5 by 4 of 68 minutes. Why? Because his speed is 4 by 5. That means he'll be taking time 5 by 4. So 68 5 by 4, that is 17 into 5, 85 minutes, right? So truck is taking 85 minutes to cover up this distance, okay? Now Mohan is reaching here at 6:30, right? That means 68 minutes before 6:30 they have met. So 68 minutes before 6:30 is what? 5:22, right? So truck and Mohan meeting each other, crossing each other at 5:22. That means before 85 minutes of 5:22, the truck might have started from Mumbai, right? Getting my point? So 85 minutes before 5:22, see 60 minutes before 5:22 is 4:22. Then 25 minutes still I have to deduct, so that 3:57. That means truck has left Mumbai at 3:57, okay? Now, apart from that, he's taking a halt of 2 hours in Mumbai. That means he reached Mumbai at 1:57. And he will take 5 hours to cross this distance. Since Mohan is taking 4 hours, the truck will take 5 hours. That means 5 hours before 1:57, he might have started, the truck might have started from Pune. That means he has started, the truck has started from Pune at 8:57. Now Mohan is starting from Mumbai at 9:30 and the truck is starting from Pune at 8:57. That means the question, difference in minutes between the time of the truck leaving Pune and Mohan leaving Mumbai is what? 9:30 and 8:57, that is 33 minutes. Pretty simple. Now let's see this problem. A problem based on geometry. Vertex A of square ABCD lies on a circle with center O. So this is, while B lies in the interior and other vertices in the exterior of the circle. So that's A, B, C, D. The circle intersects BC at F. Such that AB is to BF is root 3 is to 1. So this is root 3K and this is K. Right? Root 3k and k. AEF is 30 degree, where AE is the diameter. So this is the diameter, this is the center. AEF, this angle is 30 degree. Find the ratio of the area of the semicircle to that of the square ABCD. Okay. See, we already know the side of the square, that is root 3k. Right? AB is equal to root 3k. So area of the square will be what? 3k square. I'm sorry. Yeah, 3k square. Okay. Now we have to calculate the area of the semicircle. So that how can we do that? See, this angle will be 90 degree, right? Because this AE is diameter. So this is the angle in semicircle, right? And in this triangle ABF, we know this is root 3k and this is k. So this length will be what? 3k square plus k square, that's 4k square, that means 2k. So this length AF is 2k. Okay. Now AF and FB, FE, this is, we have to find out AE. So this is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. So relationship between perpendicular and hypotenuse is given by sine theta. Here theta is 30 degree. So sine 30 degree, that's half, is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is what? Diameter. So diameter is of this circle is 4k. That means radius will be 2k. Right? So area of circle will be what? Pi r square. So area of semicircle will be half pi r square. So half pi r square will be what? 4k square by 3k square, right? Half pi r square, that is the area of the semicircle. So that is 2 pi by 3. So the ratio should be 2 pi is to 3. So that's not there in the options. That's none of these. Okay. I hope you are clear. Now let's see this problem. Here, Ajay and Amrish decided to invest some amount of money in the ratio 5 is to 4 for the same period in a business. It was decided that at the end of the year, 10% of the profit was to be given to charity. Okay. Out of the remaining profit, 60% was to be reinvested as capital and the remaining was to be divided as interest on their capitals. If the difference in their shares is 440, then what is the total profit? Fine. Investment ratio is 5 is to 4. And 10% of the profit is to be given to the charity. That means, okay, remaining is 90%. 90%, 60% of that 90% is further getting invested. That means 40% of this 90% is actually to be distributed. So 40% of 90% is 36% in all of 100%, right? 36% of the total profit. Now 36% of the profit is being distributed in the ratio 5 is to 4. Right? That means 20% is given to Ajay and 16% is given to Amrish. Right? So that is 20%, 16%. Now the difference between them is 4%. So this 4% is actually 440. 4% is 440. That means 100% is what that we have to find out. So this is a simple calculation, 11,000 rupees. Okay, I hope you are clear. Quite simple problem. Now, two drums D1 and D2 have mixture of oil and water in the ratio 2 is to 3 and 3 is to 4 respectively. 5 liters from D1 and 6 liters from D2 are mixed to form a new mixture D3. Okay. First of all, what we do, we find out the oil to water ratio in the mixture D3, right? For that, we will be using allegation technique. You should have attended the basic allegation session. See, in drum D1, what is the proportion of oil? That's 2 by 5, right? 2 is to 3 is the ratio. So 2 by 5 is the oil in D1. And in D2, it is 3 by 7, right? 3 by 7 part is oil, right? We have to find out the overall ratio, that means in the ratio in D3. So obviously X will be lying somewhere between this two, right? Now 3 by 7 is greater than 2 by 5, right? That means this is 3 by 7 minus X and this will be X minus 2 by 5, right? Now D1 and D2, they are mixed in the ratio. We have taken 5 liter from D1 and 6 liter from D2. That means this ratio is actually 5 is to 6. Okay. So I solve 3 by 7 minus X by X minus 2 by 5 is 5 by 6. Okay. So let's solve it. 6 threes are 18 by 7 minus 6X is equal to 5X minus 2. Right. So 11x is equal to 18 by 7 plus 2, that means 32 by 7, right? So x is equal to 32 by 77. So that is the ratio of, that means the oil content in D3 is 32 out of 77, right? That means oil is 32 by 77 and water will be the remaining portion. So that's 43 by 77. I'm sorry, 45 by 77, right? Now, this mixture is actually 11 liters, right? So, I find out 11 in 11 liters, it will be this 32 by 7 and this will be 45 by 7, okay? But now we are adding 9 liters of oil more. So, it is actually 32 by 7 liters. So, if I add 9 more to it, I'll be getting 63 plus 32, 63 plus 32, 95 is 2 and this will be as it is 45 by 7, 7 will be cancelled. So the ratio is 19 is to 9. Okay, bit lengthy the problem is, but quite simple, so no need to worry. Can be done in maybe one and a half minute. Now, friends, let's see this problem. A triangle ABC inscribed in a circle C that has its sides 1 is to 2 is to root 5. Find the ratio of radius of the incircle of triangle ABC to that of its circumcircle. Now, friends, if you clearly observe that a 1, 2 and root 5, they are in Pythagorean triplets, right? 1 square plus 2 square is equal to root 5 square, right? So that means it is a right angle triangle. And in case of right angle triangle, the length of circumradius, that means R, is actually half of hypotenuse, right? So suppose this is K, this is 2K, this will be root 5K. That means R will be what? Root 5K by Okay, so circumradius we have already got. Now, what will be in radius? See, area of triangle will be what? Half base into altitude, right? So half K into 2K. So we can say half 2K square. And in terms of in radius, the area of area of this triangle will be PR, where P is semi-perimeter. So that's 3 plus root 5k by 2, right? This is what? The semi-perimeter, and this is in radius, okay? So we got the value of R, we got this value of capital R as well, right? Now we have to find out in circle to circumcircle. So in radius will be what? 2k upon 3 plus root 5, right? And circumradius will be what? Root 5k by 2, or I write root 5k by 2. So k and k is cancelled. So this is 4 upon 3 plus root 5 into root 5. Now let's rationalize it. It will be what actually? Root 5 into 3. So that's 3 root 5 plus 5. Right? So that's 4 upon 3 root 5 plus 5 into 3 root 5 minus 5 and 3 root 5 minus 5. So that is 4 into this. Now this is a plus b, a minus b formula. So that is 45 minus 25. So that's 20. Right? And this is 4. So this is 5. So 3 root 5 minus 5 by 5. 3 root 5 minus 5 by 5. Okay, so we have done good number of problems based on in circle and circumcircle. You must be knowing the formula, the relationship among all of them. So it will be very easy for you to solve all the problems based on circle and triangles. Okay, let's see this one. A water tank has two inlet pipes which can fill the tank in 12 hours and 8 hours respectively, and one outlet pipe with a valve which can empty the tank in 6 hours. The inlet pipe are open all the time, but the valve of outlet pipe opens after every 2 hours for 1 hour and then closes again for next 2 hours. In how much time will the tank will be completely filled? Okay, simple problem. See, in the first 2 hours, what is happening? 1 by 12 and 1 by 8. 1 by 12 plus 1 by 8 is 5 by 24. So it's actually 5 by 24 tank is filled up in 1 hour. That means in 2 hours, 5 by 12 will be filled up, right? Now in next 1 hour, now outlet pipe is also open. So 5 by 24 is being filled up, but 1 by 6 is getting empty per hour, right? So 1 by 6 is 4 by 24. So precisely 1 by 24 of the tank will be filled up in next 1 hour. Further, in 2 hours, 5 by 12 will be filled up. Then 1 hour, 1 by 24 will be filled up. So this 5 and 5, 10 by 12 plus this is 1 by 24 plus 1 by 24 is 1 by 12. So 11 by 12 tank is filled up, right, in 6 hours. Now just 1 by 12 is left, right. Now only tank A and B are working, and they can fill up 5 by 24 in 1 hour. So 5 by 24 of the tank takes 1 hour. So 1 by 12 will take 2 by 5 of the hour, or I can say 24 minutes. So 6 hours and 24 minutes. I hope you are clear. Now this one, a simple partnership problem. ABC enter a partnership with they put 30,000, 40,000 in this. A withdraw rupees 10,000 after 3 months. That means what is happening actually, all the data are in double zeros. So I take out double zeros. So just remove all of them. Okay, so A is putting rupees 300. So A is withdrawing 100 rupees after 3 months. That means his 200 rupees are there for 12 months and 100 rupees are there for 3 months. Okay, now B is putting 400 rupees and he is withdrawing 200 rupees after 6 months. That means his 200 rupees are there for 12 months and 200 rupees are there for 6 months. So that's 1200. Similarly, C is putting 500 rupees and is withdrawing 300 rupees for 9 months. That means 200 rupees are put for 9 months and 300 rupees are put for, I'm sorry, this is for 12 months and 300 rupees are put for 9 months. Okay, so this is the ratio of their investment and in this ratio only they will be distributing the profit, obviously. So I take out two zeros. This is 36 plus 3, 39. This is 24 plus 12, 36. And this is 24 plus 27, 59. 1. Okay. I'm sorry, 12 into 3, 12 into 2 plus 3. So that's 24 plus 3, 27. Sorry. So 3, 9, 3, 12. And this is 9 is to 12 is to 17 will be the ratio in which the profit should be distributed. Okay. Now friends, let's see this question. Here, a mango trader sells half of his opening stock every day. Of the remaining stock, he contributes 100 to the charity. After sales on the third day, he finds that he has exactly 100 left for the left for charity. What quantity did he start with? See, these sort of questions you should never try by making equations. You just go through the options, right? And you should be able to calculate faster. Okay, now suppose he is starting with 700, I assume. Now 350 he is selling. First day, 350 he is selling and 100 is going to charity, right? That means 450 is already over. Now he is left with 250. Now he is selling 125 and 100 is going to charity. So now 225 is over. That means this is not the correct choice. Getting my point? Similarly, if you take 1400, that means 700 he is selling and 100 is going for charity. The next day he is starting with 600 and that 300 he is selling and 100 is going to charity, right? So that's 1200 is already gone. Now he is left with 200. So 100 he is selling and 100 is for charity, right? So the equation is completely matching over here. So 1400 is the correct choice. Okay, you should be able to calculate fast. That's it. Otherwise, you should not make any sort of equations when you are having this sort of problems. Okay. So friends, in the next session, we'll be taking more problems. Do revise this session and the previous one and get ready for the next one. Bye-bye.